This man is Hisham El Garouj from Morocco.
He was an embodiment of everything that's needed in a great 1500-meter runner, possibly the greatest 1500-meter runner.
The biggest compliment I can ever pay anybody is that I think if I'd raced against him, he would have been a right bloody handful.
Hisham El Garouj was born in the tough industrial city of Berkane on the Moroccan coast, and it was here he began dreaming of becoming an Olympic champion.
I started racing very early. I started in 1987. I was very young. My father and mother didn't want to let me. I said to them, my dream is to become an athlete. My dream is to represent my country. My dream is to mount the podium at the Olympics.
At 16, El Garouj began training at the Moroccan National Athletics Center in Rabat.
In 1992, we won the World Junior Championship. At that time, I noticed his courage in competition, because talent alone isn't enough. You need to have the right character as a runner. I knew this boy would go far.
El Garouj rose to prominence in the 1990s with a series of outstanding performances, and he was considered the favorite to win the 1500-meter title at the Atlanta Olympics in 1996.
When I went to Atlanta, I dreamt of only one thing, that was to come first. But I had no strategy in mind, no idea how I was going to run the race. And then the drama happened.
El Garouj is right there, and there he goes. And El Garouj is gone! He's down, the bell is ringing.
I couldn't believe it. I got up and carried on, but it was too late. That was really hard, quite traumatic. But I have to say it taught me a lesson in every sense.
After this defeat in Atlanta, El Garouj and his coach, Abdul Kader, returned to their high-altitude training camp in Ifrane, in the Atlas Mountains.
Hisham trained there nearly all his career, about 14 years in all. The first 2 months of training would start in Rabat, then he'd go up to Ifrane to get used to the altitude.
Around March, we go up to high altitude. It's a huge effort, you're in physical agony sometimes. But when you go back down to sea level, you run really fluidly.
Conditioned by his high altitude training, El Garouj set a new 1500-meter world record of 3 minutes and 26 seconds, a record which still stands today. And going into the 2000 Sydney Olympics, he had been unbeaten in the 1500 for 3 years. El Garouj was the odds-on favorite to win.
And El Garouj is in the driving seat. He's in the driving seat.
But hot on his heels were Noah Nyen and Bernard Lagat, the finest Kenyan runners since Kipchoge Keino.
Just make sure that all the steps that he was taking, like each lap, each step that he was taking, I was just a meter away. So for me, I just follow him. 50 meters to go, I started to strike.
This is going to be a right fight to the line. El Garouj is not going to make it. Nyen is going to get there. El Garouj is going to lose it. Oh, I can't believe it. Nyen wins it. El Garouj. This, for me, is the biggest surprise that we've seen on the track at these Olympic Games, Brendan.
For me, he deserved to be the Olympic champion in 2000. We were great rivals, and I hope we will always be friends.
After two Olympic defeats, Athens in 2004 would be El Garouj's last chance to prove he had the mental resolve to win. But only months before the Games, illness threatened his Olympic dream.
I discovered I had asthma, and I underwent medical treatment for 4 months for my asthma. And I also lost a race. I came eighth. It was a disaster for me psychologically. It was hard.
Also challenging for the gold medal was Kenyan runner Bernard Lagat, who had finished just behind El Garouge in Sydney 4 years earlier.
I had only one thought in my head. That was to be brave, to commit fully, and never hold back.
They get underway, the 1500-meter final. 3.5 minutes for El Garouge to fulfill what everybody thinks is his destiny to win this. But
I kept myself in check. I didn't want to be in the group, to avoid accidents, to avoid falling. At 300 meters, in my head, I started to say, Hicham, now you have to go. Now you have to go.
You have to go. Tu dois partir.
What came next was one of the great feats in Olympic history. Over the final two laps, El Garouge, pursued by Bernard Lagat, accelerated constantly, running the remainder of the race in controlled 100-meter bursts, each one run quicker than the previous one.
It was a perfect 1500-meter race, the way he ran it. He was strong, he was so strong that every single move he made, you couldn't see it because it was seamless and it was just a progression. It was just a brilliant piece of distance running.
But the race was about to become even more astonishing. At the bell, El Garouge and Lagat increased their pace further as they started their final kick for the finish line.
El Garouge striking for home, chasing the gold medal he so wants for himself and for his country.
300 meters remaining, and he kicks again, and this time he's accelerating. 12.
Lagat was still behind me because he too had a dream. His dream was to become Olympic champion, to beat me once again, but I didn't want to lose. I absolutely had to win that medal because I knew that medal would change my whole life, my whole sporting career.
And he's still got more round the top bend. El Garouge is truly testing them.
El Garouge coming under pressure from Bernard Lagat of Kenya. Lagat looks comfortable. Rui Silva finishing like a train on the outside as well. El Garouge needs to fight here if he wants this one. Lagat's coming on the outside. Has El Garouge got anything left? It's going to be close.
And when Lagat overtook, I pictured those losses in Sydney and Atlanta all over again. I was telling myself, Hicham, don't lose. Hicham, don't lose.
Has El Garouge got anything left? It's going to be close. El Garouge is fighting back. El Garouge is going to get there. Come on, El Garouge. He's got it. He's got it. The gold medal.
It was extraordinary. I can tell you, that victory changed me. I relaxed. I felt light.
This would be El Garouge's last 1500-meter race. But he returned to the track 3 days later to win gold in the 5,000 meters. The first man since Paavo Nurmi in 1924 to win both Olympic events. El Garouge retired as the greatest 1500-meter champion in the history of the Olympics.
I didn't want to lose. I wanted to bring hope to my life, to my children, hope to the generations of young people watching the race. Losing in life, it shouldn't exist in your dictionary. The word lose doesn't exist. The word lose, for me, doesn't exist.
Non, ça n'existe pas.